Hey guys, welcome to JPlays, I'm Iceman, and this is my playthrough of VIII, Lacrimosa of Dana for PC. And... alright. If the next location is the last location in the game, then this will be the last video. Otherwise, there's a bit more to go, but according to this, I've explored most of the locations in the game, so... there shouldn't be much left if there's anything beyond this, but we'll see.
Okay, we made it to the Great Tree. But now what?
I don't see the Wardens anywhere.
We've been expecting you, Adol. Please wait while the path to Octus opens.
Octus?
Octus?
Look.
That's a warp gate. I never imagined one would be inside the Great Tree.
Adol, please step into the gate.
Thank you.
Ah, this thing's...
Thank you.
What? I got the boots on.
Ooh.
Now that is one big shiny rock.
This must be one of the crystals where the psyches have been sealed. Yes, I sense a vast number of psyches within it.
Okay, Adol! Let's crack it open!
Are you sure that's wise? How do we go about releasing the psyches in the first place?
The crystal just lit up.
What's going on?
Ooh.
that?
Looks like that warden hired Hydra to me.
I thought he said he was just observing us. Why is he getting in our way?
Be on your guard, everyone.
Yeah.
Allow me.
Let's go.
Release the psyches.
Hydra.
You said you were just gonna watch. Why'd you interfere with us?
That was not I who attacked you.
It wasn't?
That was my own psyche, captured by the great tree as I succumbed to despair. It has been the guardian of this crystal for many years.
But now your psyche has been released.
So we're not just releasing the victims of the Lacrimosa, but the psyches of the wardens, too. All those psyches flowing into the tree greatly accelerated its growth. If that's the case, then perhaps...
During the era in which my people flourished, countless species that lived within our Mother Ocean were invited to the surface by the Earth Goddess. Thus began the world's evolution by the Great Tree of Origins.
The Earth Goddess?
Yes, she is known as Earth Goddess Maya. She vanished after sharing with me the truth of evolution. I have watched over the Earth ever since, but the situation unfolding now is unprecedented.
What's he talking about? Did this goddess really exist?
I don't know.
Considering the existence of the Great Tree, it's not as outlandish as it sounds.
I mean, I sort of think something like that could have happened a long time ago.
I will continue to observe you. Perhaps you will come to accept the Lacrimosa as we did. Or perhaps you will find a new path and escape the never-ending cycle.
Be right back. Just need to go make some armor. Since I got the Auriculum. Okay, on to the next one. I thought I unlocked a new pathway.
Hmm.
Hopefully I haven't stuffed it up. Ah, okay. I didn't stuff anything up.
Yeah.
what is this place?
A land of ice and snow. Is this the Ice Age?
Oh. God damn it. God damn it. boss time. This will be that underwater chick. Okay, maybe not. Yeah. I had a feeling the bosses in this game were going to be the wardens.
Thought anyone would prove capable of releasing the psyches from this crystal. I found you creatures amusing at first, but you are much more remarkable than I had imagined. It seems a proper introduction is in order. My name is Minos.
We know that, you already told us.
In a bygone era of ice and snow, my people conquered this land, and I ruled over them as king. You have defeated my psyche. As such, I will concede defeat.
You're a warden, aren't you? Shouldn't you put up more of a fight?
I've done more than enough to fulfill my duty as a warden of evolution. Truth be told, I'm relieved that you have released my people's psyches. So long as they remained in that crystal, I'm certain they could not rest in peace.
This game needs more dialogue choices. Alright, be right back one moment. Alright, I'm back. Ah, that thing.
Thank you.
trees.
This area looks dense.
The powerful being is near. You should be careful, Adam.
Oh! Damn it.
Yeah.
Ooh. God damn it. Some great battles in this game. Should be one left, one boss left.
To suffer defeat at the hands of such a rudimentary species, my psyche should be ashamed of itself.
Oh, here. There's something about her that she reminds me of a character in the Zelda Breath of the Wild.
I suppose a reintroduction is due. My name is Nestor.
Yes, we know that.
At its zenith, my colony numbered over 1 million, and I ruled over them as queen.
Over 1 million?
Through our diversity of form and adaptability, my colony flourished throughout the world. And yet, even our civilization came to accept the Lacrimosa. You humans, with your frail bodies and weak minds, have no hope of defying it.
Where is this place?
World above the clouds. I didn't expect this. Sarai.
All right. One sec.
Today. Is that it?
Hey, welcome! Here you go. Here you go. This one is special. This one is special. This one is special. See you later.
Please come again.
Let me see. You didn't do much.
Hmm.
pumpkin. Yuck. Hate pumpkin.
How does it taste? Rakota taught me how to make it.
Yeah.
You think so? Oh, that's a relief.
Good job, darling.
I know you delivered the baby safe and sound, but you should still rest. Until you're fully recovered, you're already taking care of the baby. Let me handle everything else.
Thank you. But I'm actually feeling much better these days. Oh, my ring? Ed gave it to me the other night. Beneath the beautiful light of the twin moons.
I was reminded of the night that we first met, so it just seemed like the perfect time to give it to her.
Yes, it was such a special moment. By the way, I heard that you found the ruby for this ring, Adol. Thank you very much.
Hope seems happy too.
I can't believe how much you've done for us, Adol. If it wasn't for you, the three of us wouldn't even be here right now. I can't thank you enough.
Yeah, you really are our hero. If we ever get off this island, and you happen to be in Greek, please, pay us a visit whenever you have time. I'll prepare you the best set of adventuring gear.
I wonder how big our little one will be by then. I hope we meet again someday.
All right, back to it. Oh. Oh, man.
Thank you.
the? Right, need to heal up. Oh. Alright, need to heal up again. Considering the boss battle's over there. That is some massive boobs.
Tree of Psyches has grown enough. I can sense a large wave of Psyches coming from the Valley of Kings.
Yeah!
We did it, Adol.
You actually managed to release all the Psyches.
Sarai.
wanted to be addressed by that name.
Huh? What do you mean?
As I said before, my true name is Ura. My species descended to Earth from the skies above, possessing the power of mimicry.
Mimicry?
It's the ability to perfectly copy another creature's shape and features. With our power of mimicry, we claimed dominion over the land and flourished. But we were eventually greeted by the Lacrimosa, and I was selected to be a warden.
If they came from space, why didn't they just go back to space?
When the Eternian era began, I descended to Earth once again, so that I may find a new Warden of Evolution among the Eternians.
Ah.
Then how'd you become the Princess of Eternia?
To find the person whose soul burns brightest, I thought it best to insert myself among royalty. So I snuck into the palace, where I learned the young princess was deathly ill.
Then...
Yes. After Princess Sarai succumbed to her illness, I used my mimicry to assume her place. I reconstructed her personality and appearance, and made it part of my own. Then a few years later, at the Temple of the Great Tree, I met you, Donna.
Then... the Sarai I've always known was... Donna...
Don't make this more personal than it is. I did what I deemed necessary to protect this world.
This story again?
Even if that's true, think about Donna. Her best friend was an imposter. Poor Donna.
Imposter? Necessarily. No. What I did was unforgivable.
If you know that, then... What's happening to me?
Something's wrong.
This won't forgive what I've done. Control over my mimicry is becoming unstable. The way you spoke just now.
It's been a while, Donna.
Sarai?
Huh? What's going on?
What is going on?
Don't ask me, Squirt.
I'm Sarai's personality, as reconstructed through Ura's mimicry. To be clear, I'm still not the real Sarai. But I'm the Sarai that you've known ever since we were young.
How is this possible?
Ura is a kind and virtuous person by nature. She must be suffering from carrying out her duty as a warden. The fact that you released her psyche is no doubt affecting her, too.
How is this possible?
Donna.
Sarai.
I'm sorry to put you through such pain. I'm so sorry I couldn't stay with you until the end. And I'm sorry about Olga.
No.
Donna.
I want to stay and talk to you more than anything. But we have to go.
Yes. You're running out of time.
Adol, let's return to Seren Garden.
Adol, please come back to Octus once you receive the power. If you intend to stop the Lacrimosa, I'll explain what you need to do.
You will? That's a big help.
Yes. But for now, you must hurry to Seren Garden.
Whoa! Look at the tree!
The tree of psyches has grown so much. It's mesmerizing.
Wow! It's beautiful!
So what? So how does one go about receiving this power? Does Donna receive it?
No. The power of the psyches conflicts with providence and natural law. It exists in direct opposition to the essence wielded by Eternians. Therefore, I would like to ask you, Adol, to receive the power.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You can do it!
Now, face the tree and raise your sword, the symbol of your strength.
Still tying.
Whoa!
So this has the power to stop the Lacrimosa? Yes. The psyches of species past and their collective will to live. It seems to have worked.
What an incredible looking weapon. That's definitely not your average sword.
The preparations are complete then.
Yes. Let's return to Octus. Sarai is waiting for us. if we manage to stop the Lacrimosa, I still don't know what's going to happen. We've come so far. I've been waiting for this for so long. Yes, we will. When the final battle is over, I'm certain we'll stand victorious. But first, I have to confess something to you. Actually, I need to apologize to you. You and I, we had a fascinating bond. We shared a consciousness, and through that we were able to travel together too. Through it all, I started to become unwaveringly convinced of something. That your soul burns brighter than any other soul in the world. Adol, I think I was the one who selected you to be the Warden of Evolution for humanity. I may be the reason you're forced to suffer in the future. And yet, despite everything, you're still trying to help me prevent the Lacrimosa. I'm so sorry that I forced this burden on you. Well, when you put it like that, it's actually a little embarrassing. Still, we didn't have Mistletoe, the Sword of Psyches, like we do now. I'm glad you're the one who received the power of Psyches. In all honesty, I could have volunteered to receive it myself. But I wanted to fight by your side until the very end. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to deceive you. In hindsight, you're the best person who could have received it. Yes. Adol, I'd like you to have this. It's a keepsake for my mother. It's the reason why I've always felt so compelled to help others. Normally, this ring seals essence. I modified it somewhat so you could make use of it, Adol. It would make me happy to see that ring on your hand while you hold that sword.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Let's fight together, Adol. Side by side until the very end.
Luckily for her, I already had the other half.
Thank you.
We did it!
The view from this height is stunning. I'm sorry to suddenly ask you to accompany me up here. I would like to personally thank you once again. Please accept this as a token of my gratitude. It's an accessory from my personal collection. One that I thought would suit you best. If you don't need it, I will not be offended if you choose to sell it after we escape this island. I'll be blunt. What is your opinion of the Roman Empire? Are you referring to our military might? That's not necessarily something to be proud of. With each passing year, Rom's wars of expansion continue. Her territory grows ever larger. Her desire for conquest shows no signs of waning. What I'm about to tell you, Adol, stays between us. You've attracted the attention of certain individuals within the Roman military. They might decide to cause trouble for you in the future. Much like what happened in Salcetta. Please, be careful.
Yes.
I should be thanking you. Your presence is an inspiring one. I brought you here to thank you, yet here I am, inspired once again. Leo told me that I need to start thinking of ways to establish my influence in Rome. That being said, escaping this island is our top priority. Let's see this task through to its end.
Upgrade. All right. How can I help you today? Leave it to me. All right, finished. Is that it?
Alright, I'm gonna end this one here. Hope you guys have enjoyed watching this video. If you'd like to be notified when I go about putting up the next video, which very likely will be later tonight, but we'll see. Be sure to subscribe on the YouTube side of things, then you'll be notified when that video is made available. Alright guys, have a good one.